Hi guys, welcome to Stack Streams. In this tutorial, I'm gonna show you what is batch programming and why it got named batch programming and how does it works. Actually, batch programming is nothing but running a batch files. Like if you give some 5 or 6 commands, it will execute 6 commands one after one another. Like it that means it runs the program like for batch for like it runs that program that batch of commands at a time, so it is called as batch programming. Like after completing first command, it goes to second command. After completing second command, it goes to third command. Like for example, if you want to do if you want to perform a task like deleting temp files, recent files, and history, these are the particular things to we will do for speeding up our PC every day. So all we do is to create a batch file which does all these things, and you need not to have any software to do this programming. All you have to do is you should have type Windows R and CMD, and you can run whatever the thing like Notepad, or if you want Notepad you can shut down also. You can also shut down the PC like typing shutdown.exe. I will not do that now, and you can do whatever you want. Like what actually it is, an MS-DOS operating system in Windows. At earlier times we don't have that much hard disks and memory, so everything is command line interface. After we got from Windows NT, we got that GUI graphic user interface, but in earlier days we have command line interface, and whatever you want to do, whatever you do you want to access in your PC, all you want is command line interface. You can only do that using CMD, that is MS-DOS. In MS-DOS, whatever we want, if you want to install software, if you want to install any program, if you want to run any program, everything is done through CMD. Now it is everything is graphic user interface. You can do whatever you want. It have complete access to the PC, and whatever the things you can't do using Windows, you can do everything using the CMD. Like for example, I think I have written the file for deleting temp files. Yeah, I can run this. Yeah, it will check this programming. It will it will delete every temporary files, and that's it. You are done. You can also directly run that file for deleting temp files. Now my system is clean. In this way, whatever you want, you can do. And thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe.